did not blame the pharmacist. She was just doing her job. But there must be something wrong with our system when people who need healthcare do not get it when they really need it. It saddens me to see the elderly who struggle to walk in pain because they could not afford to pay for an elective surgery. And it pains me to see an elderly become housebound because they cannot pay for a simple cataract surgery. Or someone who becomes isolated and unable to have conversations with their family because they cannot afford to buy a hearing aid. Hearing aid subsidies come with criteria, and many of our elderly do not meet that criteria. In every single one of these old people that I see my grandparents, I see my aunties, my uncles, my parents, maybe even myself. If we can make treatment more affordable, our elderly can continue to live in their own homes fairly independently. Why do we have to wait until the elderly become bedbound and become a huge burden to their family members, and then we ship them off to a nursing home? The cost of nursing home beds are not cheap either. How many more nursing home beds do we need for our aging population? We have received feedback from many of you during our walkabouts and through our emails that there are issues that are troubling to you. Issues such as increasing cost of food at hawker centers and food courts, loss of jobs to foreign workers, the high cost of HDB flats, rising transport costs. Yet, buses and trains remain jam-packed and trains break down frequently, and receive many other more feedback. The SDP has been working tirelessly since the last general election to formulate alternative policies to improve the well-being of Singaporeans. I believe that the government does not have monopoly of ideas. There is no perfect solution to all the problems that we are facing. But the government has the responsibility to craft policies that serve the well-being of Singaporeans. When we look as Singaporeans from all walks of life, as human beings with hopes and aspirations, then perhaps we can have policies that are more humane. When we look as Singaporeans, as people who want something better for the future generation, a happier, less stressful life, then perhaps we can have policies that will uplift our people and not dumb them down as economic digits. I have a stake in this country too. I want this place I call home to be around for a long time. We ask that you give us the opportunity to be a voice in Parliament so that we can speak up on issues that are important to you. During our walkabouts, many individuals express that they do not believe that their vote is secret. The current government has created much fear in us. It is highly unfortunate that in this year, 2015, there persists an overall climate of fear. How can it be? Today, people still fear that voting for the opposition will compromise their career, their application for HDB flats, or their children's scholarships. And our PAP-led government makes no attempt to allay those fears. Let me clarify this misconception. Whether you vote for the PAP or the SDP or any other opposition party, no one besides you will know. you have all your personal details. Now the number on your ballot paper is not there for the purpose of identifying who voted for whom. It is there to prevent fraud. So ladies and gentlemen, I urge you, do not be afraid. Your candidate here, Mr. Sarah Sivan, is well experienced to represent you. He will be your voice in Parliament. If you want change to happen, you have to be that change maker. And I quote Mahatma Gandhi, be the change that you wish to see in the world, because it all starts with one vote. Stand up for what you believe in, for you have the power to make a difference with your vote. Vote for the SDP for a better future.
In life, we are confronted with choices. We can choose to live passionately and for what we believe in, or we can continue this path of timidity and fearful silence. Either we live and dare mightily, or we cower in fear without spirit. And let it not be remarked by history that we were a generation who remained on our knees even as our overlords stripped us of our freedom and dignity. Let us stand up to those who would oppress us. Let us look them in the eye and tell them that they will demean us no more. Let us speak up for the poor and the broken. Let us live free and dignified lives. Let us stand mightily, and in so doing, know what it truly means to be Singaporean.